Shirts off, pants down. Today we have some pretty exciting stories, so let's just go ahead and jump right into it. As always, before the video gets underway, everything will be in the description down below. If you are not subscribed yet, please make sure you go ahead and join the family. But our first story today is brought to us by a previous, I guess, Gymshark athlete or social media influencer, fitness model, whatever you want to title him, Ryan Casey. Now, Ryan Casey recently published a video on his YouTube channel titled, basically, Dropped by Gymshark. And I've seen that as a very common thing on YouTube's platform with a lot of fitness models and fitness people out there being dropped by Gymshark, basically out of nowhere. And I was sitting here at my computer like, okay, this must be because just a couple days previous, Ryan Casey had just uploaded a video admitting that he was no longer natural, that for, you know, the past year he hasn't been natural, that he has been taking SARMs.
How about you steroids? No. How about you SARMs? Yes. So, with SARMs, I started taking them around this time last year.
But by the way, guys, who called that one? But that's not what I want to dive into. In fact, Ryan Casey actually earned my respect immensely for coming clean and doing essentially what my channel is all about. And that's just everyone being open about everything they do to help give those who watch those certain individuals a better mindset of what they can achieve naturally or unnaturally. But to give you a little breakdown, Ryan Casey, throughout this being dropped by Gymshark video, mentions his reasons of why he believes he was dropped.
So we've been talking back and forth and we've decided to, you know, not renew your contract. I was like half asleep. I was like, oh, okay. All right. And they were like, you know, I'm sure you're not surprised. I was like, no, I'm not. We'll talk about that. And yeah, they're like, I'm sure you're not surprised. I was like, oh, no, I'm not. And then the call ended. I was like, all right, bye. And then literally 10 minutes later, I'm like, what the fuck just happened? So posting. So obviously when you sign a contract, you have posting requirements. So I wasn't meeting those requirements. That was one thing. Obviously, you know, on my Instagram as well, I wouldn't post for a while. I think,
you know, he brings up that his manager or the guy he would associate with or talk to for Gymshark, they didn't really get along. Ryan Casey didn't meet his contract with posting enough. But in the back of my head, and I know Gymshark and I know how they are as a company, I know they just saw this as an opportunity to drop Ryan Casey because he came clean about SARMs. As brutal as that is honestly the reason, and they probably came up with this hoax idea, and they know that they had previously had issues with Ryan Casey, you know, either not uploading enough or something along those lines, where they're like, okay, we need to get rid of Ryan because we can't have unnatural athletes on our team. Now, this definitely isn't the end for Ryan Casey. In fact, if you are watching this, Ryan, this is all for the better. You do not want a company who doesn't support you 100%, which is why I never work with those types of companies. I only work with companies who I know are going to support me and everything I want to do. So whether that's you joining up with a new company who's okay with you talking and doing whatever you want, or starting your own clothing line, or doing whatever you want to do, honestly, this probably opened a lot more doors for you. But it honestly just goes to show how shady of a company Gymshark really is. And I can almost guarantee, from a business standpoint, it was because Ryan Casey came out with that video just a couple days prior saying that he was taking SARMs. I don't know what it is about Gymshark, but for some reason, they do not want people who are unnatural on their team, or at least don't admit that they're not natural. So keep your head up, Ryan. This isn't the end of the world. I can guarantee that. In fact, it's probably going to be the best thing that's ever happened to you. Since Ryan Casey came out with this SARM video, now it also brings into question, is David Laid also doing the same thing? Because as we know, when Ryan Casey was hitting all those PRs in the gym, who was there beside him? David Laid and Dylan McKenna. But definitely let me know down below. Now, the next story is on FaceSensor and Yunette Garcia. And if you didn't know, a couple months ago, I made a video on FaceSensor and Yunette Garcia's breakup. And I guess basically to give you a rundown, FaceSensor said that he broke up with Yunette Garcia. He got a ton of hate, a ton of criticism for doing it because so many people find her so attractive.
They don't like it, okay? I just need to be honest with you guys. All I see on all of my social media accounts is I took a big L, I dumped the hottest girl in the world in order to pursue Call of Duty, I retired from Call of Duty, and I'm just taking all these L's left and right, and at first it's like, you know, whatever, I'll roll with the memes. But now it's like to a point where people genuinely think that this is how it went down and this is the actual truth, and I have no one to blame but myself, because that's exactly what I said.
But he said he wanted to pursue his Call of Duty championship, and then recently came out with a video stating that he is basically retiring from playing Call of Duty competitively. Everyone's sitting here like, you just broke up with Yunette Garcia to go pursue playing Call of Duty, and now you're retiring from Call of Duty just a few months later. But then FaceSensor released another video basically giving the truth of the situation, and a video he didn't want to make, but he felt felt that he had to because of all the hate and criticism he was taking. And I guess essentially to summarize, and from what I picked up from it, FaceSensor basically called out Yanette Garcia for being what seems to be a gold digger.
So when she understood how much money I was making on YouTube, she wanted to get a percentage of the videos that I was making. And for me, I didn't feel comfortable with it. Here's what I'll do. I'm not gonna pay you any money. I'm not gonna give you money for these videos. So I was like, you know what? I'll pay for all the bills. I'll take really good care of you. I'll make sure that you're treated really well. I'll pay for the visa. Like, I literally did everything to make sure that she was good.
She wanted compensation for being in his videos. She didn't want him to get any monetary value for having her in his videos. And it almost seems like she wasn't letting him live his YouTube life, which is what he wants to pursue.
That really ticked me. And I have to be honest with you guys, is when I bought this girl a car, most of the times if you were gonna buy your girlfriend a car, they would be really happy and appreciative of it. I just couldn't give her a dollar. I couldn't give her money because it just wouldn't feel right. But I would treat her really nice. I'll buy her really nice things. I'll take really good care of her. I wanna buy you a car. She's like, that's great. I'm like, and I wanna film it. She's like, no, you're not gonna film that. You can't film that. I'm like, listen, like, I have to find a way to balancing, like, making good content.
So FaceSensor ultimately in this video brought up all the situations and scenarios of why they broke up, why they didn't get along. That wasn't because of the Call of Duty, and that was because he ultimately just wasn't happy and wanted to pursue, you know, his passion and his dream of being big on YouTube, which I can't hate him for that. Honestly, all the respect to FaceSensor and everything he's done to live his life as happy as he possibly can. If that means not having Yanette Garcia, then so be it. You're probably better off. Because at the end of the day, it comes down to what makes you happy, not what makes other people happy. And although it probably looked good for his social media, especially his YouTube channel, to have one of the top Instagram models featured all the time and to be dating them and to use for clickbait thumbnails, if you're ultimately not happy, it's not worth it. So I respect FaceSensor for coming out with that video, clearing the air that wasn't because of Call of Duty, that in fact they just had underlying issues that they couldn't work past. But those are all the stories for today, guys. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to leave in the comments down below what you thought of either the Ryan Casey story or the FaceSensor and Yanette Garcia story. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, if you are not subscribed yet, please make sure to go ahead and do so. As always, make sure to stay shredded, stay aesthetic, signing out.